Hello everyone. So we are going to continue with a lecture on integration. As I had said in the last lecture, that integration is nothing but finding out the area under the curve. Okay. So today we are going to find out how we can find out the area under the curve. Okay. This is the curve y is equal to a function, any function of x. This is the x-axis. And this is the y-axis, and we have to find out the area of the curve under the curve between the points A and B. So we said that in the last lecture, we said that we have to divide this curve into a n rectangles, okay, where n will be a certain number. So let's take one rectangle as an example here. Okay, if we take this example, if we are going to find out the area of this rectangle, how are we going to find out? Okay, so this part that is there, this one small part, we will be denoting as delta x. Okay, this will be denoted as delta x. So we have divided the curve between the points A and B into n rectangles, and one of the small parts is delta x. So here you will see delta x. What is the value of delta x? Delta x means, since this is one part, we are dividing B, this is A and this is B. So what is this distance equal to? This distance is equal to B minus A. Now, since we have divided this curve into n parts, so obviously delta x is B minus A by n, right? So one of this rectangle, size of the width of this rectangle is delta x, which is B minus A into n. Now we have to get the value of this, right? The value of this part in order to find out the area of this one particular rectangle. So if this is the ith part, okay, this is the ith interval, or we call it the ith interval, where I will be changing from 1 to n, right? So if first interval, this is the first interval, here in this part I will be equal to 1, this part I will be equal to 2, and so on until the last part, this one will be I equal to n. So if we take any ith interval, it will be the i. Okay, so what is the value of this function at that ith interval? That is what we call f, the value of the function, or the value of y at that point of x, which is f of x I star. Okay, so what is that equal to? So now, since we know we are starting from A, so in the ith interval it will be A plus the number of delta x's, that will be the 1 delta x, 2 delta x, and so on until delta x I. So if there are I intervals, so the whole from A to that part, it will be delta x into the ith interval plus A. So if this is A, this will be A plus delta x, right? This will be A plus 2 delta x. This will be A plus 3 delta x. This will be A plus 4 delta x until we reach B. So in the ith part, it will be A plus delta x I. So we have to find out the value of x. What is the value of x at the ith interval? It is A plus delta x I, right? So we have to find out the value of the function at the A plus delta x ith interval. Okay, the A plus delta x into I. So what is the value of that function at that point? So it is A will remain as A. We have found out that delta x is B minus A by n into I. Okay, so now finally we have to sum up all the areas of the rectangles for where I is changing from 1 to n. So we express it like this: A is equal to limit as n tends to infinity. This is called the summation sign. This is called the summation sign, where I is changing from 1 to n. F of x I, value of the function at the ith interval into delta x. This was formulated by a mathematician whose name was Riemann. So this is called the Riemann's sum. So basically, this A equal to limit as n tends to infinity, where I is changing from sum of all the rectangles where I equal to 1 to n is denoted by fxi x star into delta x. This is the value of one rectangle. So if we take n rectangles where I is changing from 1 to n, we will get the sum of all the rectangles, and that is basically the area under the curve between the limits a and b. So the process of finding this area from a to b has been proposed by this mathematician whose name is Riemann, and it has been appropriately named after him, and this is called Riemann's sum. Okay, so we will take some examples on how to find out the area given by the help of Riemann's sum. Okay, now in order to find that, we have to remember a few rules. So number one rule, the summation, this is called the summation symbol, I equal to 1 to n of a constant a. So if we have any constant a and we have to find out the sum from the I equal to the first interval to the n interval, it will be a into n. This is rule number one. Okay, this is rule number two. So summation I is equal to 1 to n of a into the I is equal to a summation i is equal to 1 to n of i. Okay, so a is a constant, so a will be coming out of the summation sign. Number three, this is a very simple rule, summation from I is equal to 1 to n of xi plus yi will be equal to, we can break the sum into two parts, I is equal to 1 to n of xi plus summation of another function yi from I is equal to 1 to n. Okay, this is rule number 3. Rule number 4, summation of I is equal to 1 to n of I is equal to n into n plus 1 by 2. This is rule number 4. Rule number 5, summation of I is equal to 1 to n of I square is equal to n into n plus 1 into n plus, 2n plus 1 upon 6. Okay, this is rule number 5. And rule number 6 is summation of I is equal to 1 to n of I cubed is equal to n squared into n plus 1 whole squared upon 4. So these are the 6 rules which we have to remember in order to solve problems of integration by finding out the area under the curve between the points A and B. Okay, so we will take some examples that will make this Riemann sum very clear.